今早的時間就得知美國呢是就何志平賄賂非洲政要案呢有個裁決，他是有多項控罪被裁定是罪名成立，只有一條關於洗黑錢的罪行呢是被裁定無罪的。咁我哋睇返成個案嘅審訊控罪書等等嘅資料呢，就發現其實成個案件香港嘅角色係非常之關鍵的。第一呢，何志平自己去代表嗰個叫香港中華能源基金會，去做副主席同埋秘書長，去接觸聯合國嘅官員呢，呢、這個基金會嘅網頁自己講呢，呢、這個它是中國華信能源有限公司的全資設立的非公務基金，在香港註冊的。第二呢，我們看回法庭的文件和相關的證人呢，發現有部分的賄款呢其實是經香港匯豐銀行轉過去美國。還有第三，就是相關的交易和協商呢是曾經在香港發生過，亦都是何志平有參與。咁所以我哋總括呢幾方面嘅因素呢，我哋有理由懷疑今次何志平賄賂非洲政要嘅案件呢，喺香港其實係有人去協助甚至係教唆何志平去進行有關嘅咁嚴重嘅貪污案件。而相關的賄賂的資金呢，亦都是源自香港，所以我認為香港的廉政公署以至警方呢，是有法定的權力和職責去全面調查何志平今次的案件是不是有任何在香港的公司或者人士涉案，當中是不是有涉嫌協助教唆賄賂的情況，或者是洗黑錢的情況。司法管轄權那方面未必香港可以咁快就做個結論話有冇權去作出檢控，但最少一個咁重大的國際貪污案件呢，我哋香港的執法機構呢是必須要協助海外的執法機構呢去調查有關的案件，提供啲資料。我哋睇返政府俾出嚟嘅數字呢，其實我哋最近睇返涉及洗黑錢嘅可疑交易舉報呢，係已經創咗五年嘅新高，達到 9.2 萬宗，係近幾年一路有個上升嘅趨勢。我哋香港作為國際金融中心呢，一定要非常之小心去避免俾國際社會是以為香港成為國際的貪污、行賄以至洗黑錢的中心。所以今次這麼重要的案件呢，我認為特區政府必須要非常之重視，執法部門是應該要及早去行動，去追查相關的資料，和要聯絡美國的執法當局提供相關的協助，希望可以透過調查的合作去將兩地的資料呢是結合，再去追查相關的涉案人士和公司的刑事責任。 我主要想講的是這幾點。 OK， 有沒有問題？沒有問題。 OK， 麻煩
我想
做英文。 OK，
我想做
叫你TVB 都問英文，你一次過問完好嗎？你個你個麥喺度。
我諗住
我本身。哦，咁好，另外做，冇做啲師傅。
我都英文先啊嘛。
係咪英文？講埋英文 ，OK 啦。
好。
哦，你 set 翻麥先。
Is it beyond jurisdiction for the U.S. government action to arrest Petrenko? And the other question is, and what and how can Hong Kong authorities follow up?
First of all, according to the court document and the evidence discovered by the court, I have reason to believe that some of the white money were transferred from Hong Kong and the so-called NGO that Patrick Ho represent and try to bribe the African politicians, the registration address is in Hong Kong, and the court also discovered some of the negotiation of the corruption dealing will happen in Hong Kong. Therefore, I have reason to urge the Hong Kong law enforcement agencies to conduct a full investigation to try to trace the other main culprit or co-conspirators and try to fully cooperate with the American law enforcement agency to try to fully investigate this cross-border corruption case.
Do you think because of this high profileness of the case, do you think if Hong Kong ICAC didn't do anything about it, is it going to have any impact on Hong Kong's image in terms of the cleanliness?
I don't want to jump to the conclusion at this moment that the ICAC haven't done its job. I will send a letter to the ICAC and to urge the Commission, based on the information discovered by the court, to try to start an thorough investigation. And Hong Kong, as the hub, financial hub of Asia, we have to defend our image that we will not tolerate any money laundering or corruption activities in Hong Kong, especially such kind of serious international corruption case.我冇任何嘅證據去提出任何質疑，話呢兩單嘅刑事案件咧係涉及中美嘅貿易戰咯。我相信所有嘅刑事案件咧都係必須基於證據，同埋法庭亦都會充分考慮是否有足夠嘅證據去作出裁決。而美國亦都係相對嚟講，是一個司法獨立的國家，美國政府有很多案件上到法庭亦都未必一定勝訴，所以我不覺得話任何的政府一定是可以透過這些刑事案去向其他國家施加壓力謀取貿易的利益。我想如果有任何的證據是顯示到這個這樣的情況，我再評論吧。
Implication of the case as well, because the China has been quite frequently being viewed as like, you know, making use of donations as the method to expand its soft power.
Soft power, yeah.
In developing countries. So, what is the implication on that of the case or on the judgment in this method of the expansion?
First of all, it's a very important case to show that those so-called middlemen, they cannot try to blame anyone because they have the knowledge such kind of practice is illegal and they are subject for imprisonment if the case is convicted by the court. And I think it's a... Sorry. I think it's a very I think the court sent a clear message to mainland China and those companies that the international community will not tolerate any corruption practice among countries, especially corruption case in relation to politicians or even country leaders. And anyone try to violate the international orders or law, they have to bear the consequences ultimately. Okay.今次的案件顯示呢，任何人去代表任何公司、機構、國企、民企去做任何的行賄的行為呢，都是有非常之大的風險。他們很可能呢是要面對不同國家的司法管轄權，可能面對一個非常嚴重的檢控和一個很長的監禁的刑期。所以任何人呢絕對不能夠因為任何的理由或者利益去參與協助或者教唆這類型的國際貪污的罪行。好像中央政府經常說雖遠必誅，如果你是參與其中，是涉及國際的貪污的罪行的話，無論你在天涯海角，只要人家有司法管轄權，隨時可以拘捕你、檢控你，或者是引導你去歸案咯。OK， 唔該曬，唔該。